All right, so starting off first. Now let's compare a conditioned base coins here, okay? So different types of condition. So 1939 Denver minted walking liberty half dollar. If you don't know where the mint mark is, if we look here on the back, you zoom in there, that is where that D mint mark or the S mint mark will be. Now that is for the 1939D, and this coin is graded at about uncirculated 50, and the coin sold for a little over $20. But if we go to the same exact year, the same exact mint mark, and we look at this coin that is graded by PCGS at a mint state 68, and we look at the weird and pretty unique natural toning to this coin here, that is pretty incredible looking. The grade makes the coin really valuable here. So the coin grading scale only goes up to 70. This is at a 68, meaning that is nearly a perfect condition coin. The other one was graded at a 50, so that is the difference. So there's a huge difference in prices based on, you know, the condition or the grade of your coins. Now this coin here sold for over $25,000. That's right, over $25,000. Now, what you wanna look for on your 1939 D and S Walking Liberty half dollar coins is a double die obverse. So you wanna look for doubling on the phrase "In God We Trust," which we can see here in the image displayed, as well as on the date 1939 itself. So if you wanna see your coins up close, make sure you guys get a USB coin microscope. They are available right now on couchcollectibles.com. Link is in the description of every single video. Now here is a 1939S that has that double die obverse. So there's doubling on the front of this coin. Now this coin here sold for over $180. Now keep in mind, if you do have one of these coins that has the double die obverse, but the coin is in very poor condition, it probably is not gonna sell for as much money. So if you got an error on any coin and it's in really good condition, then it's always gonna be a good thing because it's always gonna sell for a lot more. Now if we look at this coin, this is the 1939 no mint mark, graded at about uncirculated 55. This coin here only sold for around $40. But if we look at the 1939 no mint mark that is graded at a mint state 68, we are talking over a $19,000 silver coin. So this half dollar here seriously sold for over $19,000, which is pretty incredible. And if we zoom in there on the back, you will see that there's no mint mark on this one, like I said. So there will be either no mint mark, a D mint mark, or an S mint mark right there. Speaking of the D mint mark, you always wanna look for this on your D mint marks as well on the Walking Liberty half dollars. This is a repunched mint mark, so you can see how that D has been repunched north of its first impression there. And then we see that again, a different example here on this mint mark. So always be on the lookout for that. Like I said, get you that USB coin microscope, couchcollectibles.com, and you'll be able to see your mint marks up close like this. Next up is a very high graded 1939S San Francisco minted Walking Liberty half dollar. Now, like I said, these high graded coins sell for a lot of money. It's graded at a mint state 68, so close to a perfect grade. And this coin sold for nearly $13,000. $13,000. Again, if we look at the lower graded version of it, it's not too low a grade, but it's a graded at about uncirculated 50, which we can see there on the coin slab, and this coin here sold for a little over $60. So a huge, huge difference in prices based on the condition of a coin, and really, you know, if your coin has any types of errors, that is always gonna affect the value. There's so many things that affect the coin's value. I've actually made a whole video on that, so be sure to go check it out, and don't forget to go subscribe in the middle, check out the videos to the left of me, and until tomorrow, I will see you all in the comment section below. This is Couch Collectibles, and this is where I disappear.